Hello, I'm here at Hammerfest with Raging Speedhorn. How are you doing, guys?
We're good.
It's all right, a bit cold.
Yeah, it's freezing, isn't it?
Yeah.
Whose bright idea was that?
I don't know, you should have really put it off until June if you ask me, but here we are.
Yeah. Put the heating on, it's inside.
Yeah, you'd think so, wouldn't you?
Yeah, that's a big problem. So my friend here wanted to know, first of all, is the name about the fact that you get a raging horn when you've had speed?
Yeah, it is.
First things first.
Not me personally.
Long story short.
I get nothing.
Yeah, I've never had sex. So it's your 20th anniversary as a band this year, and you're celebrating it with a one-off show in London with all the original members.
Yeah, it's going to be wild.
Is that just like, is the idea just to treat the fans, give
well,
them a bit
we just, we've been talking about doing
school.
It for a while, and it was always kind of going to be a one-off show in London, but it's all finally come together, and we're like, look, it's 20th anniversary, let's do it. Our old manager, Dave, got in touch with us, and he was like, look, I'd really like to sort of be involved and help you do it. Are you all up for it? And we just all went, yeah. So that's about as far as we've got with it so far, but yeah, we've booked the lineup, we've booked the venue. And that's it.
You don't need to do much else since
we haven't talked yet. We haven't practiced, but it'll be all right.
You got some time. I think you'll be okay.
Fine.
Are the newer members going to be joining in at any point?
Yeah, Jay and Dave's old band Scourge will be on the bill.
Oh, cool.
Along
that's
with...
a nice way of incorporating everyone.
Yeah, we're better than Speedhorn as well.
Yeah. Opinions. And then Jim Palmer, our other current guitarist, his band, Charger, who weirdly Frank actually sings for as well, will also be on the bill. So yeah,
greedy.
It's kind of a big old party. That's the way we want it. It's our 20th birthday, basically.
Aww.
So we're all going to get really, really drunk and have fun. So.
So Gareth is writing a book about the first 10 years of Speedhorn, right?
Yeah, it's going to be... embarrassing.
Is it going to be a bit of a tell-all? Are there some embarrassing things in there?
There's definitely some embarrassing stories through that way.
Let's just say there's a lot of pages
stuff.
Of John sat in the back of the van being really stoned.
Yeah.
Literally half the book.
That's probably not that exciting to read, actually, is it?
Well, I had different strains.
Any big secrets coming out? Like anything fun? You punched up someone from another band or something. You seem like the kind of band that might punch someone.
Are they going to be talking about your...
I have punched a few people in my time, once or twice.
Are they going to be talking about your front covers with Kerrang, John?
What's that?
Frank's got a front cover. I haven't got a front cover of Kerrang.
They each have like one front cover each.
No, we don't. No.
Frank posted his the other day. You should probably like Google John.
No, they don't.
Is it not there?
There's a
fucking pedo in it. Fucking Watkins, the prick. Wanker. Fucking lost profit.
Fucking pedophiles. How inconsiderate of him to be a pedophile and ruin your magazine cover.
Me and my mate Colin and a fucking pedo.
That was the worst thing he could have possibly done.
Fucking ruined it for me. My moment of glory.
So apart from being in a magazine with a paedophile, what's been a career highlight of yours so far, both of you?
I don't know.
Playing Hammerfest, of course.
Obviously, yeah. It's not the first time. It's not your first time, is it? You've done.
My highlight's probably drunkenly approaching Yannick Gers at a Kerrang Awards after show. Going up to him and be like, you're one of my favourite bands ever.
Remind me who that is. Is that the dude from...
Iron Maiden.
Oh, right.
Did you ask him where he got his leggings from?
I didn't know.
<His leggings. laughs>
I kind of walked up to him and was like, you're one of my favourite bands ever. Like, you know, but I'm really drunk, so I'm going to go away before I upset you. And he went, two things. I was like, oh, I've upset him already. It was one, you're at the Kerrang Awards, it's free booze. If you weren't drunk, I'd slap you. Two, should we go to the bar for a beer?
Oh.
So, yes.
That's cool. I'm not very happy with Iron Maiden today because they were like playing it loudly when I was trying to be hungover earlier.
A lot of Iron Maiden like throughout this venue today.
Yeah.
Do they have other CDs or is it just Maiden?
I think maybe it's because Blaze Bailey is here, but they were just playing the Bruce stuff. Yeah, anyway. Maybe just to rub it in his face.
Blaze Bailey isn't Iron Maiden. No one talks about that era.
He fucking does.
Yes, now we're getting somewhere.
Yes.
We should probably stop this here. Wait, no, one more thing. Are you working on any new material?
Yeah, we've just finished recording a new song with Russ Russell.
Was he here earlier? I thought it was him.
Like a ghost at the moment.
Yeah, he had a bit of a heavy night last night.
I thought he looked weird. Great. Yeah, when's that due to come out?
We're not sure yet. We're going to release it as a single sometime this year, hopefully. But we're just kind of in the process of writing a new album at the minute and playing the odd show here and there. So, yeah, hopefully it should be coming out this year. It's called The Beast.
Nice. So even though it's the original lineup, do you think they'll be playing anything from the new album at the London show?
No, I think it's just going to be mainly the hits. The golden oldies.
The hits.
The ones we want to play. How about that? There you go.
Well, I'm looking forward to it, guys.
Yeah, it should be good.
Thank you for talking to us and enjoy the rest of your Hammerfest. Thanks.